See, there's a hell of a difference. 60 to 7, you better be on your knees every day. Because every day after that, 7 times 70 is the blessings. Amen? Oh, y'all ain't gonna help me. I'm already wild for sound. I'm already wild. Because the truth hurt. What Jack Nicholas say? Y'all can't handle the truth? Y'all ready for somebody to lie to y'all than to tell y'all the truth? This is my Bible. Everything in it is true and reliable. This is my Bible. I invite y'all to get one. I got some up here. If you don't have one, get some power. Amen. Read some positive stuff. Stop being negative. Turn yourself around. As this story today I'm about to tell y'all is true. I'm in the great chapter of Luke, the 17th verse, starting at the 11th chapter. 11th chapter. Yes, ma'am. They had 10 lepers. They were standing on a corner. See, they didn't have a hospital on every corner for people when they had injuries and deformities back then. They categorized you. They put you in a corner somewhere. Y'all can't come across this line. So these 10 people, they were sick. The title tonight is, what percentage are you? I got 10 people that Jesus healed. Now it happened. He went to Jerusalem. He passed through the middle of Samaria and Galilee. When he entered a certain village, there he met 10 people who were lepers, who stood far off. When they noticed Jesus, they lifted up their voices and cried, Jesus! When your money funny, sometimes you got to holler out, Jesus! Yeah. When you need some help or job, you got to holler out, Jesus! When your body is wrecking with pain, you got to call out Jesus. When your relationship is going sour, you got to call out Jesus. When your job fired you after 30-some years, you got to call on Jesus. And the crowd told them to be quiet. Look what they did. They got even louder. Jesus, have mercy on us. Jesus, they lifted up their voices even louder. And when he saw them, he said to them, go and show yourself to the priests as they were cleansed. All Jesus had to do was speak. And they were healed. They were cleansed. Here's my PowerPoint for tonight. And one of them saw that he was healed. He returned with a loud voice and thanked God. He glorified God. He got on his knees. He praised God. He lifted up his voice in front of everybody and glorified the Lord. He did his happy dance. Jesus looked at him and said, where were all the 9? What happened to the other 9? If I healed 20 and only one came back, whatever happened to the 19? If I healed 30 and only one came back, what happened to the other 29 in the picture? God has done something for each and every one of us. Amen?
Amen.
And then half the time, only time we call on them is when we need something. Amen?
Amen.
Store up some prayers when stuff started happening. Pray on yourself when everything's going good, when you got a pocket full of money, when the relationships are lovey-dovey. Amen?
Amen.
Sneak in your secret closet and resigned from the basketball program here. 7 years is completion. 8 years is new beginning. I had 139 kids. In a minute, we're going to sign them up. Give God his praise. Give God the glory. Let us pray. I'm not going to hold y'all. Lord, I pray for the families over in France tonight. Over 100 and some people killed. Over 60 some people injured. Father, I pray that you go into their lives and help these families, bereaved grand families, as they go into burials, into the hospitals. Father, we know if you are in it, all things are new. Father, we know as men, we make mistakes. God, you don't make mistakes. I pray for the Russians, the 224 that were killed in one plane, the devastation, the devil reason for the kill, steal, and destroy, but he can't have our youth. He can't have our future. He can't have tomorrow because it's some prayer warriors. We pray. I pray for the food that the people that's preparing the food for the nourishment of our bodies. I ask that you bless them, that they took time out of their busy days. Prepare us a meal. All we got to do is just walk in there and eat. Amen? I thank God for the pastor of this great church. He is the salt and I am the pepper. You can't mix dinner without the two. I pray for the little ones. Scripture say, raise up the children the way they should go. And when they get old, they won't depart. Pray for the children. If you don't pray for yourself, pray for the children of the neighborhood. Pray for the children that you come in contact with. I pray for the ladies that's in the audience. I pray for the fellas. In Jesus' name, and everybody say amen. Amen.